name is Iris Freitas.
I'm Chris Mason.
And we are both members of the Amnesty International Group 39 in Pittsburgh. Amnesty International was founded more than 50 years ago, and its core work is on people who are incarcerated because they voice their opinion. So we call them prisoners of conscience, and Amnesty International is basically researching what happened to them and then writing letters or pressuring on their governments in other ways to free them.
One of the events that we take part in that is held across the globe is the annual Write-a-thon, which is Amnesty International USA sponsors it, but usually it's all over the globe often. And it's held around Human Rights Day, which is at December 10th every year. So we usually will hold the Write-a-thon shortly before or after that date. And we decided to change it up this year and actually had some poets come and read. We also invited local groups that work with human rights, either locally or with an international perspective, which also opened up how many people were there. And we wrote about 550 letters that night, but we had a lot of people at home writing too, so I'm sure we'll say like 600 at least, which was very, very successful. But we met Brady, and he asked, you know, he loved the event, and he asked us to that he wanted to do some sort of a gallery show and involve Amnesty International local group, Pittsburgh. And we're like, sure, let's talk about it. Because we really were trying to show, like, we wanted to be involved in ways that art is used to express social issues, especially with human rights. We are all volunteer with the local Pittsburgh group. We are, you know, affiliated with Amnesty International USA, but we don't, other than getting print materials, we don't get any financial support from them. So we have to do a lot of our own fundraising. We do meet monthly to write letters, as well as try to have events like the Write-a-thon, and oftentimes we'll have film events throughout the year. So we do have some costs, mainly postage. So it was really great that we can continue to do that, since we have a very active core of people in Pittsburgh for Amnesty. And so we have our website, our local Pittsburgh website is amnestypgh.org. So people can log on there and just see what we're doing and get more information. Amnestyusa.org has a lot of cases that we might write on, but they can at least start with our website if they want to get more involved.